A cell may need to have a substance cross the plasma membrane against its concentration gradient. This requires energy and is accomplished by active transport. The sodium-potassium pump is an example of this process. A large protein in the plasma membrane provides the doorway through which sodium and potassium ions can move. ATP is the energy source. Sodium inside the cell binds to the protein. The addition of a phosphate group from ATP changes the shape of the protein, and the sodium is expelled. Now potassium binds to the protein. The phosphate is released, and as the protein returns to its former shape, potassium is moved into the cell. Sodium can once again bind to the protein, and the process repeats as long as there is a supply of ATP. Striated or skeletal muscle is attached to bone and makes movement possible. A muscle's structural pattern is a series of increasingly smaller parallel units. The muscle is composed of fascicles. Each fascicle consists of several fibers. Each fiber is an elongated cell with many nuclei. Within each fiber are myofibrils composed of thick and thin filaments made of protein. The regular arrangement of these filaments gives striated muscle its striped appearance. The basic functional unit of a muscle is the sarcomere, a section of a myofibril. One is shown here, bordered by the crooked blue lines. A sarcomere is composed of thick filaments of myosin, in red, and thin filaments of actin, in blue. Muscle contraction is the result of these thick and thin filaments sliding past one another.
To activate skeletal muscle, the central nervous system initiates an action potential that travels down the spinal cord to the motor neurons. As the nerve fiber branches, the action potential travels down each branch. Each nerve fiber branches many times and stimulates several skeletal muscle fibers. The union of the axon and muscle fiber is called the neuromuscular junction. Zooming into the microscopic level, each branch of the neuron has a terminal that invaginates the muscle fiber while remaining outside the muscle fiber plasma membrane. The action potential arrives at the axon terminal. In the terminal, the action potential causes the release of acetylcholine from the synaptic vesicles into space between the axon terminal and the muscle fiber, called the synaptic cleft. In the synaptic cleft, the acetylcholine binds with a receptor site on the fiber membrane, which opens a chemically gated ion channel. Sodium then rushes through the ion channel into the muscle fiber, causing an action potential to form on the fiber membrane. The action potential spreads along the muscle fiber. As more nerve branches activate additional fibers, the action potential spreads over the entire muscle. Upon activation, the muscle contracts. Skeletal muscles, like the biceps brachii, attach to bone via connective tissue called tendons. Muscles are composed of bundles of muscle fibers. Each bundle is separated by connective tissues known as paramecium. Each fasciculus is made up of muscle fibers, which are separated by connective tissue called endomysium. Skeletal muscle fibers, or cells, are multinucleated and striated in appearance. Muscle cells are composed of subunits called myofibrils. Each myofibril is made up of several myofilaments. The two types of myofilament shown in red are composed primarily of the protein myosin, and a thin myofilament shown in blue composed mainly of the protein actin. The repeating arrangement of thick and thin myofilaments serves as the fundamental subunit of striated muscle contraction. These subunits are called sarcomeres. A sarcomere contraction is represented by the shortening of the distance between the Z lines. The sarcomere shortens because the thin filaments slide past the thick filaments. In 3D, each thick myofilament is surrounded by six thin myofilaments arranged in a hexagonal pattern. The 3D arrangement of sliding myofilaments is the microscopic basis of muscle contraction.
At the start of a contraction, stored calcium ions are released into the cytoplasm. Calcium ions expose binding sites on the actin molecules. Globular heads on the myosin can bind to these sites, forming cross bridges. Repeated binding and release moves the filaments relative to one another, and as this occurs simultaneously in many sarcomeres, the entire muscle shortens or contracts. This process requires energy in the form of ATP.